thank you, Sheriff Ford, for being here. It's always great to see you here in our community. And I'm thrilled, as always, to be joined by my wonderful colleague, Sherry Leiter, who is a wonderful supporter of the LGBT community. Sherry, thank you so much for coming. Spirit via their staff. I want to make sure to acknowledge them. Ricardo Flores from Congresswoman Susan Davis's office. Justin Moore, State Assemblymember Marty Block's office. Diane Moore, State Senator Juan Vargas' office. My colleague, Councilmember Marty Emerald's office. True. We know and we love our own representative of the San Diego Police Department, Lieutenant Mark Hansen. Mark, thanks for being here. I have the great honor of introducing a hero in our community. And many of you know about Ben Dillingham because he is a legend in San Diego, in the San Diego LGBT community and beyond. He has a lot to his credit, and I'll repeat some of the things you already know. He served as the Chief Financial Officer and Controller for the San Diego Metropolitan Transit Development Board. Many of you know that he was the Chief of Staff to San Diego Mayor Maureen O'Connor. He was the Board Chair for the AIDS Foundation San Diego. He is a part of the Wall of Honor Committee and sits on the San Diego Human Dignity Foundation Board of Finance. He's served in a number of other roles in the community. Many of them are a long list, and you'd kill me if I read every one of them, so I won't do that. But many of you also have a sense of, but you may not know, that he is a veteran. More importantly, he is a decorated combat veteran from the Vietnam War. He was a Marine. Once a Marine, always a Marine. We have a few Marines here today. He has the Bronze Star Medal with a combat V and an Army Commendation Medal. Those are our recognitions. He attained the rank of captain, and I think this is where I wanted to just speak about what I think of Ben Dillingham. Some of you know that he was appointed by Supervisor Mark Roberts to the County Board of Supervisors County Veterans Advisory Council. And I had an opportunity to go once a month, early on a Saturday morning, is that right, Ben? Both of us were not necessarily awake, but we were there. And Ben was there to advocate for veterans, but he was there also to advocate for our community. And you can imagine in a crowded room of World War II, Korean, and Vietnam-era veterans, it was difficult at times to advocate for our LGBT service members. But Ben Dillingham did that. He did it magnificently, time and again, inserting our community's voice at that table. And as we know, what is the saying? If you're not at the table, you're what?
Dinner.
On the menu. Ben never let us be on the menu. He helped us to build the movement that eventually ended Don't Ask, Don't Tell. And so while Ben has done many, many things for this community, and we are lucky, damn lucky, to have him here in San Diego, I want to thank him tonight on the eve of Veterans Day for all that he has done for advocating for veterans and specifically for our LGBT veterans. Ben, can you come on board?
To our many allies in the offensive to claim our right to openly serve,
especially Presidents Clinton and Obama, our eternal gratitude. This wall is our community's groundbreaking effort to recognize and restore the humanity stolen from those who dared to don their country's uniform despite being persecuted for their sexual orientation. May this wall forever challenge all Americans to ask the why of it, and let our LGBT community always stand ready to tell the wall's tale of steadfastness in the face of institutionalized inhumanity. Our pride is not in having borne the yoke of oppression, but in liberating ourselves from the silence which equal death. As with most memorials, it is difficult to envision the scope of the struggle, sacrifice, pain, and anguish that stand behind each name to be inscribed on this monument. We served in degrading and forced silence about ourselves, and were frequently brutally and humiliatingly exposed. Now we hope our names will provide a dignified visual voice to the injustice with which our nation denied our very existence as valued citizen soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines. While our successors may now serve openly, it remains a concession without the required affirmation of an apology for past wrongs or an expression of national gratitude for service extraordinarily well performed in the harshest of circumstances. As justly we take pride in the battle well fought, acknowledge the bravery of those who gave much, and cheer the glorious assertion of our inalienable right to serve honorably, we are mindful that we have yet to wrest unconditional surrender from our implacable foes. This wall reminds us, lest we ever forget, that tyranny, oppression, hate, and prejudice will continue to command a roll call of those willing to serve in our armed forces from the LGBT community in the defense of our own rights and freedoms, those of our fellow citizens, and those of the downtrodden masses worldwide. This wall affirms the right, duty, and opportunity all of us have in advancing the sacred cause of civil rights. To the veterans of the fight, those who've contended valorously in the arena of this and other great causes, and those who will be inspired to pick up the sword in trials yet to come, may this wall stand as an expression of our willingness to sacrifice self for liberty and provide eternal encouragement to the brave of our LGBT ranks who will forever demand to live free. Thank you.